Hello everybody, and welcome to Paul Gardens. Today is March 3rd, 2020, and we're going to be doing a grow update. As you can see here, a lot of our onions and peppers are doing very well. We had two seeds not germinate, our Casper eggplant, as well as our chocolate pepper, but more about those later in the video. Today we're going to be doing a little thinning on our peppers. Most of our seeds did germinate, so we do have two peppers per cell. We're just going to be trimming the weaker of the two. We also have our tomatoes and our jalapeno peppers from our seed starting mix experiment, which we're going to be thinning and up potting also. This is the remainder of our herbs from our seed starting experiment, our smaller herbs and herbs that were not growing as well. I did compost already, but these ones I believe I'm going to be giving to family and friends and keeping some for myself. Down here is our first batch of lettuce. This is two small trays of butter lettuce, one of my wife's favorite, and we're gonna start succession planting these now. We're gonna be doing one planting every week. Some of the first ones will most likely have to be grown inside under grow lights. I'm trying to figure out my timing with lettuces because I did buy starts last year rather than growing from seed. So I'm really working on my timing and which ones grow the best. Counting back from our last frost date, we are actually going to be starting all of our tomato seeds in the next 4 or 5 days. I actually might wait a little bit longer just due to space constraints. I started all of my tomatoes last year right around March 18th, and they got to a really good size before they went in the garden. I really don't know if adding a couple of weeks onto that is going to benefit me at all, but I know it'll take up more space as the plants will have another 2 weeks of growth in them. Now, these are the two plants that have not germinated at all. I tried them in 3 cells each and 0 of the plants have germinated. So I'm going to be using the paper towel method to see if I can get any of these seeds to germinate before I put them back in soil. With the chocolate pepper, I only got about 15 seeds total. So I'm concerned that I'm not going to get any of those. With the Casper eggplant, I have a few more seeds, so I'm fairly confident I should be able to get something out of those. And here we have our up-potting station. We have our plants that we're going to up-pot, our tomatoes, our aromas, and our jalapeno peppers. We have the pots that they're going into. For the tomatoes, I have a little bit of a deeper pot so I can sink them down a little bit so they can build a little bit better of a root structure. And then for the jalapenos, I'm just a small basic round pot. Both of these were purchased on Amazon. I'll put links down in the description. And then we have our craft sticks and pen for marking. Let's get to it. Popped it out of our tray. I took off the first leaves, and I'm going to bury this right up to the base of the first set of true leaves. Fill up my pot 3/4 of the way with soil. Now I'm going to make a little hole for our plant to sit in. Put this down, break up any of these chunks, and then dig down right in the middle. And there we have it, buried up to its first set of true leaves, our tomato seedling. Now let's get them all done. And there we have it. We have 6 Roman tomatoes and 6 jalapeno peppers potted up into their larger pots. I did leave some of the jalapeno peppers in their small cells. I do want to see if they're going to grow a little bit more in those cells and see if they surpass the ones I just transplanted. I am concerned about transplant shock just because they are so small and it's a little bit earlier for what I normally pot up a pepper with. So we're going to keep coming to some of the small ones as kind of an insurance policy. Thank you for joining me today at Paul Gardens. Be sure to subscribe for more great gardening content. Catch you next time.